Installing Imaginet Timesheet on-premise is really easy. I'm going to double-click the Timesheet MSI. I'll click Next. After reading the End User License Agreement and accepting it, I'll click Next again. If you're not updating from an older version, leave the checkbox empty. If you're migrating from an older version, select I am migrating from an older version. Here we'll put in the connection string to the old database. Now I'm going to enter in the URI for my Team Foundation server. Next, I'll give it a connection string to a database that the timesheet installer will create. If you're going to have more than 5 users, you're going to need to enter your timesheet license key. I'll leave this empty for now, which will let me use timesheet for up to 5 users. For IIS, we have to tell timesheet which website we'd like to install timesheet under. We'll also want timesheet to install it under a new virtual directory called timesheet. We need to give timesheet credentials for the application pool. I'll hit install to let the timesheet installer complete the installation. Now I can open up a browser and browse to my new timesheet site. To install reports for timesheet, extract the reports.zip file. You'll see there's a number of RDL files here. Log into reporting services. I'll click new data source, enter in the name timesheet DS, and I'll put in the connection string to my timesheet database. We'll enter in some credentials and test the connection. Next, we'll create a new folder for the timesheet reports. We'll navigate into the folder, and for each of the reports, we'll hit upload file. Once the report is uploaded, we're going to have to manage that report. I'll hover over the report and select manage. Then I'll click on data sources, and we'll have to fill in the 2 shared data sources. The first one is the TFS report data set, which we're going to set to TFS 2010 report DS. Then we'll scroll down and hit browse to set the timesheet data source to the newly created timesheet data source. Repeat the previous steps to upload each file and set the data sources